Hello, my art-loving friends. So I had been mulling for quite a while to start a daily art challenge for myself. Well, basically, I just wanted to get up every day and sketch or draw or paint something simple for an hour, maybe. And that is one of the reasons I decided to do that doodle wash challenge in March that I already put out on my channel, and I'll link that for you over here. And then right after that, I received the email about the Sketchbook Revival, and I don't know how I got on that list or if I saw it in someone else's video, I can't remember, but I was like, oh, Sketchbook Revival, that would be great because I really want to use my sketchbooks. I have so many of them. So many of them are gorgeous and wonderful, and I can't wait to use them, but you know how it goes with sketchbooks, right? Well, at least for me, the thought of doing something that would use my sketchbooks and increase my art skills just seemed really appealing. So I joined the Sketchbook Revival, and in this video, you'll see what I did. So Sketchbook Revival is supposed to be a 14-day challenge, and I only did 6 days because I had a lot of other projects going on. I just recently launched my Patreon site. You can go check that out. There's a lot of fun tiers to get extra content and have some fun with us. So point is, I did do work every day, not always in my sketchbook, but I did this religiously for 6 days and it was so much fun. And I do have the emails and the recordings of the last 8 days that I do want to look at because it gives you ideas of tips and techniques that you might not think of otherwise, and some of them are really fun. So I will at least glance at the rest of those videos and see if one of them or two of them or 10 of them, okay, there's only 8 that I didn't look at, catch my eye. You should get out your sketchbooks and play with me today. So in Sketchbook Revival, there are 2 sessions that you can choose from each day, and I chose this session out of the 2, and it was Sketchbook Play Exercises to Ignite Your Sketchbook Practice. And the idea here was just to make blobs of color and then doodle in them. And the instructor doodled flowers or just shapes or Zentangle types of items. But I wanted to try a bunch of different faces just because it seemed like a really fun thing to do. And I tried to choose faces that were different from each other with maybe different expressions, different hairstyles, male versus female, and so on. And so I just had fun with it. And I used the glass dip pen that I got from one of you. And it is so nice to use, and I made sure I used a permanent ink with it. And for all of the 6 days that I participated, I chose to use my Etcher A4 sketchbook, which is 100% cotton paper, 105 pounds. And the session I chose for day 2 was called Artpreneur Affirmations. And so you're supposed to just do some creative doodling and a little plaque that gives you a saying that makes you feel good about that. And this one I wasn't totally excited about, but at the same time I thought, oh, this isn't going to take any time at all. But this one actually took a really long time between sketching out all these cute little things and then painting all the little detail. This one took a while. I forget how big of time lapse I put this on, but the footage itself took quite a while, and I think I had it on 20 times the speed. So yeah, this one took way more than an hour, but it was fun. I wasn't like totally thrilled with it or the idea at first, but now that it's done and I go back in my sketchbook, it is my favorite page. I absolutely love it. One thing I regret is that I did not catch on camera at the very end. I put some white gel pen highlights on the words, and that helped a bunch. But you'll see here, it's pretty fun. The session I chose for day 3 was called Expressive Watercolor Portrait, and I had a third of the page unused from when I swatched the Sonnet watercolors that I got from one of you, and I wanted to use them to fill up the rest of the page. So if you want to check out that video, I'll link that up in the corner and then in the description box below when I got these and originally swatched them out. So Expressive Watercolor Portraits, you're supposed to just draw in a person however you want. So I just freehanded this person and I didn't bother recording that part. I thought it would be boring, but so I'm just bringing out my Sonnet watercolors, and at the end here I'll add in a little bit of black Posca marker and I think white Posca marker just for some of the details. This one was really fun. I think the colors I did were maybe just a little too vibrant, but that's okay. That's good to know these Sonnet watercolors can get that vibrant, and I cannot wait to use them again. It'll be in my upcoming list of things to get to again sometime in the far future because we have so many fun art supplies from you guys that I've received
that it may take a while before I get back to these, but I was really, really grateful that I had the chance to use them and fill up the rest of the page where I started them. Day 4 was called Draw Just About Anything with Confidence, and it's so fun. She gave us this little method to kind of get your sketch going and then just not think about it too much. But this was challenging because I used my dip pen with the purple Higgins permanent ink, and that's what you're supposed to do. You're not supposed to sketch with a pencil first. You're supposed to sketch right away with your permanent ink. And so there's a couple things on the face that I wish I could change, wish I could do differently, but this was a fun exercise regardless, and the dog in this picture turned out okay. At first, when I did that mouth, I'm like, oh my gosh, that's horrible. But when I finished it, I'm like, okay, that works. That reads dog. I can deal with that. I can live with that. But anyway, this is a picture I had of my niece and her dog, and that's what I was just trying to do is paint it, but basically draw it without any practice, without any erasing, and I love that glass dip pen, by the way, so thank you. You know who you are who gave it to me. I love it. It is so much fun. I used it every single day, I think, in the Sketchbook Revival. Every day that I could, anyway. There is something a little bit freeing about just going right in with your sketch with permanent ink, but at the same time, it's almost terrifying. It's like, no, one mistake, it'll be so obvious, like on her cheek there. I'm like, oh, so sad. I just can't go back and erase that little bit and adjust her chin a little, but it's okay. It is what it is. For day 5, I chose the session From Bill to Tail Feathers, How to Sketch a Bird. I thought it looked pretty fun, and it definitely looked more fun than collaging, because I don't really enjoy collages. I don't enjoy doing them. Too many parts laying around everywhere. So at least this one was just watercolor, pencil, and stuff. So we are sketching and painting a bird standing in water, and it was fun. I enjoyed this one. It didn't take too long. I think it was still probably 45 minutes to an hour with the sketch, but it was enjoyable. And I don't know if you've noticed in all of these, but I am using my Himimiya watercolors. That is the one we are trying to use it up in our Use It Up challenge, except for the day I used the Sonnet watercolors. But every other day and every other time, I'm trying to use these Himimiya watercolors. And I'm also using them in my intermediate watercolor class, just trying to use them up. I think it's going to take a few decades, but yeah, we'll see. I'm getting short on a few colors now. I will show that to you in an upcoming video eventually, but yep, I'm here using them up. No, I'm not. I'm not using them up, but I am using them at every opportunity, trying to use them up. And on day 6, I chose Create Like a Kid Again with Charlie O. Shields, and this is where you just put blobs of color down on the paper. You let it dry, and then you see what you can come up with. So what do you guys see in this painting right here? I can't not see what I drew now. And again, I'm using my glass dip pen. And Charlie O. Shields, by the way, has some really fun books out there that I picked up a few for my niece because she likes to draw and paint. And he has these storybooks where you have to finish some of the drawings. And I thought that would be perfect for her, so I picked up a couple of those after this session, and I'll get her a small pack of gel pens to go with it, and her birthday present is taken care of. And I supported a local artist. Well, local, I supported an artist who is awesome and energetic and full of great ideas and inspiration. So what did you guys see in this one? Let me know down below. Did you see the same thing I did, or did you see something completely different?
This was so much fun. And in fact, because I am signed up for Skillshare and what is it? The class 101. I just took a painting Hyun class, and I don't spend a lot of time going on there and working on those. So I thought this little hour in the beginning of the day could be dedicated at least 3 days, 2 days minimum a week doing those classes, because otherwise my money that I spent on my memberships there will be wasted, and I don't want that. So it's a practice I will try to put in place. What do you guys do? Do you have any daily art practices? I know some of you do. All right, guys, had fun here as usual. I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.
All right, it is giveaway winner time. In last week's video, I had a giveaway, and we are gonna find out who's the winner. And I wanted to put all the names that entered into an actual paper like hat or bowl and pick a piece of paper out. That did not make sense, but you know what I mean, because it just seems so anticlimactic here to just stick in the the URL of the video, and then like before you click, it has a name picked, and it's kind of anticlimactic, like I said. But anyway, that's the URL of the video where the giveaway was, where you had to enter in the comments the word giveaway. And I have 56 comments, but we have to filter it on a specific text, which is the word giveaway. One winner. Okay. I actually need two. I need two winners because I have two of these sketchbooks to give away. And start the raffle. Pick the winners. Here we go. D, Neil, and Bev R.
The dog's coming down the stairs. Oh, just a little one. Oh, nope. Now the big one's coming. I'll be back. This will be loud. This was so much fun. In fact, I am signed up for some... Oh my goodness. Why can't I get that right? Cat's gonna meow. Molly! We're downstairs! She's like, where are you guys? She knows we're down here. We're down here every day.
If you're ever wondering why I have fur in everything I do, here's the cat. She's laying on my desk. And look how furry she is. There's fur everywhere. She's quite happy though. I know this looks like a mess, but it's really not. That's just cords that have to be bunched up on that side of my desk for all the lights and power cords for my computer, plus paintings that are in progress from my son's girlfriend. And the cat is laying in the middle of everything. But she's a brat. Here is the view of her from the other side. She's laying on a bunch of cords and stuff. It looks quite uncomfortable. And that right behind her is something awesome I will be showing you guys in a future video. Anyway, there she is. She's so cute.